Borodan Shamai. I am Lord Welshy, and welcome to Stardew Valley. This is a farming game, it's an indie game, and I'm really looking forward to trying it. It's got some lovely 16-bit style graphics, which always grabs my attention. So I've created my character by the name of Welshy, incredibly original. Chosen the farm name, and we've chosen the style, so we'll see how this goes. Who are you? And why are you in bed? And for my very special grandson. Oh, it's Grandpa. Hello, Grandpa. I want you to have this sealed envelope. Okay. I got an envelope. Oh, is this his will? No, don't open it yet. Have patience. Now listen close. There will come a day when you feel crushed by the burden of modern life. I feel it every day. Every darn day. And your bright spirit will fade before a growing emptiness. Okay, quite morose words. When that happens, my boy, you'll be ready for this gift. Okay, I'm ready for it now. Now let Grandpa rest. XX years later. Joja, join us. Thrive. Yeah, so everyone's just working in these little cubicles. Someone's been terminated. Hopefully not literally. That guy looks incredibly happy. He has a funky cowboy hat. Is he licking his lips? I don't think I like that. And there's a skeleton on the far right. He's just had enough. It looks like I have as well. Ugh. I'm done. Oh, I kept that with me, did I? I took it to work. Dear Welshy. I don't think my grandfather would actually refer to me as Welshy somehow, considering he's Welsh as well. So, anyway, if you're reading this, you must be in dire need of a change. The same thing happened to me long ago. I'd lost sight of what mattered most in life, real connections with other people and nature. So I dropped everything and moved to the place I truly belong. I've enclosed the deed to that place, my pride and joy, Pentrahowl Farm. It's located in Stardew Valley on the southern coast. It's the perfect place to start your new life. This was my most precious gift of all. Now it's yours. I know you'll honour the family name, my boy. Good luck. Love, Grandpa. So if you're wondering anything behind the name Pentrahowl Farm, that is or was my grandfather's farm back in South Wales. So it kind of fits that it's on the south coast because it was in the south region of Wales. But I just wanted to call it Pentrahowl because it just kind of, I don't know, I have really, really good memories of living near my grandpa's farm. We lived literally about 50 yards up the road, so I spent a lot of time on that farm. That may be a bit of why I've kind of put off playing this, to be honest, because I'm not sure how I feel about it. Anyway, P.S. If Lewis is still alive, say hi to the old guy for me, will ya? Sure, Grandpa, I can do that. If he's still alive. But yeah, so that's your new fact about me today is I used to live next to my grandfather's farm and I spent a lot of time on that farm while I was growing up. So I definitely have an affinity for kind of nature and farming. Obviously a game experience is going to be quite different, but yeah, I've got a good feeling about this, about getting back to Pentrahowl Farm. So I'm off the bus. Who's that? Robin. Hello, you must be Welshy. Yes, I am. I'm Robin, the local carpenter. Mayor Lewis sent me here to fetch you and show you the way to your new home. He's there right now, tidying things up for your arrival. Oh, fantastic. The farm's right over here, if you'll follow me. Auto-follow! Oh, that's in a bit of a mess. This is Pentrahowl Farm. Oh my goodness! It's in such a state! What's the matter? I think you can see what the matter is, Robin. Sure, it's a bit overgrown, but there's some good soil underneath that mess. Well, that's the important thing. With a little dedication, you'll have it cleaned up in no time. Great! So I've got to get it cleared up before I can really get to work planting anything, but that's fine. And here we are, your new home. It's nice, I like... Oh! What are you doing in my house? Oh, it's Lewis. Ah, the new farmer! I like your hat. Welcome, I'm Lewis, mayor of Pelican Town. I didn't live near Pelican Town. You know everyone's been asking about you. It's not every day that someone new moves in. It's quite a big deal. Is it indeed? So, you're moving into your grandfather's old cottage. It's a good house. Very rustic. I like the quotes around rustic. Rustic, that's one way to put it. Crusty might be a little more apt, though. Robin, how dare you? This was my grandfather's home. He built it with his own two hands. Rude! Don't listen to her, Welshie. She's just trying to make you dissatisfied. I cannot speak today. So that you buy one of her house upgrades. Oh! Humph. Ah, so we're on to your sales tactic, Robin. Anyway, you must be tired from the long journey. You should get some rest. Tomorrow you ought to explore the town a bit and introduce yourself. The townspeople would appreciate that. Okay, I can do that. Robin doesn't seem impressed anyway. Oh, I almost forgot. If you have anything to sell, just place it in this box here. I'll come by during the night to collect it. You come around people's houses at night to collect stuff? Okay. It's a bit of an odd task for a mayor, isn't it? Collecting things himself in order to sell? Well, good luck. Thank you, Mayor Lewis. I shall try my best. So they've just left me to it. We didn't have cockerels on the farm in Wales, I can tell you that much. So I didn't have to deal with that every morning. Right. Movement is WASDA. Run is... Oh, no. Okay, it's on auto run. Run is... That's walk. Okay, that's fine. And right click to open. I got some parsnip seeds! You received 15 parsnip seeds. Here's a little something to get you started. Mayor Lewis. Okay, so we can plant parsnips! And there's something in my journal. Getting started. If you want to become a farmer, you have to start with the basics. Use your hoe to till the soil, then use a seed packet on the tilled soil to sow a crop. Water every day until the crop is ready for harvest. This is very similar to, or certainly calls back to, the Harvest Moon type games. I mean, I didn't play the earlier ones. I started off with A Wonderful Life on the GameCube, and that was one of my favourite games on the GameCube, actually. I absolutely loved it. It was to do with really the exploration... chop wood. Sorry. Scythe. There we go. Aha! Brilliant! Yeah, so what I've really liked about It's a Wonderful Life, the Harvest Moon game, not the film, was really the exploration of the town and kind of the seaside area. I thought it was a bit odd having the way the farm is positioned quite so close to the sea in that game, but I just really, really enjoyed it. It's something I put hours and hours of time into. I think it's kind of the repetitive nature of, similar to what I'm doing here, kind of clearing things down with the scythe and various tools and just exploring, creating your own kind of farm and small business kind of thing. It's just something I really, really enjoy. It's quite sedate. You kind of go at your own pace in this one. I think Harvest Moon, you tend to have like a time limit, really, but from what I understand, you don't have quite such a time limit in Stardew Valley. Right, let's go meet some people in the town, shall we? Oh, there's a sign there. What's that say? Where am I going? Bus stop ahead, Pelican Town to the right. I want to make sure I don't accidentally scythe someone, walk up to them and go, "Pya!" Oh, hey, that's a nice pair of legs. Hyah! Don't want to do that. Right, where's the people of the town? There's a person of the town. Whoops. This is Shane. I don't know you. Why are you talking to me? Does that count as greeting someone? Yes, it does. Brilliant. So meeting someone can just be as simple as going, hi, and they go, who are you? Well, hello there. I'm Gus, chef and owner of the Stardrop Saloon. So I've met him. Ooh, floating question mark. Whoops, I was clicking the wrong button. So, year one, spring, Monday, the 1st. Oh, Lewis's birthday's on the 7th. Why? What? They put people's birthdays on the public calendar? This is a really close-knit community. Okay, fine. I keep clicking the wrong button. Right. I can just purchase stuff off you, but I don't want to do that at the moment. Whee! Hello! Would you like to buy some medicine? It's a pleasure to meet you. I'm Harvey, the local doctor. Good stuff. Hello, Harvey. Nice to meet you. What's this? Is life sometimes difficult? Do you ever have trouble staying focused? Talk to your doctor about... Bloody hell. Provoloxinone. Provoloxinone is not for everyone. Side effects may include insomnia, severe anger, uncontrollable swelling of the throat, permanent discoloration of the lips, hair loss, and a stroke. In extremely rare cases, 1 in 500 test subjects have experienced... Nearly had it. In extremely rare cases, 1 in 500 test subjects experience complete disintegration of one or more bones. So we're not going to be taking that stuff. I wouldn't class 1 in 500 as extremely rare, necessarily. I'd say it's uncommon. Don't spread disease. Cover your sneeze. This clinic is licensed for medical practice by the Ferngill Republic Health Authority. I cannot do the fast talking. My tongue goes... right. What do we got here? I wish to read you. I can't. Let's go in. Let's meet some more people. Hello. That's Gus. Who are you? Ah, Mayor Lewis told me you just arrived. I'm Marnie. Hello, Marnie. I like your hair. I do like that little green hair tie you've got at the end there. Very nice. Let's try talking to you again. I sell livestock and animal care products at my ranch. You should swing by sometime. I probably will. Right, let's talk to you. Hey, it's Mr. Welshy, the new farmer. Please, Mr. Welshy was my father. You can call me Sir. I'm Pierre, owner of the local general store. If you're looking for seeds, my shop is the place to go. I'll also buy produce from you for a good price. I don't know why I said produce. It's produce. Although produce is one way of saying it, I guess. Depends on where you are, I suppose. Tell me down in the comments. You're not good friends enough with Abigail to enter her bedroom. Oh. Okay. You're not good friends enough with Pierre or Caroline to enter their bedroom. This makes sense. I wouldn't let someone I barely know into my bedroom either. Oh, that's right. I heard someone new was moving on to that old farm. Oh, this is Abigail. She has very nice purple hair. It's kind of a shame, really. I always enjoyed exploring those overgrown fields by myself. They won't be overgrown much longer. I'll be fixing it. What on earth is this? Altar of Yoba? They have a church in their house? Well, yeah, because this is the house part of the building. Huh. Okay. To each their own, I suppose. I mean, you know, if I had the space to construct my own kind of area of worship, I suppose I might. Not really the kind of thing I'd do, I guess. Who are you? Oh, hey, so you're the new guy, huh? Cool. This is Alex. I'll see you around. Okay, bye. Dog. There is no dog in there. There's the Stardrop Saloon. I'm just going to be spending most of this episode just kind of exploring, I guess. It's locked. Open 12 p.m. to 12 a.m. Who are you? Did I meet you already? Hey, I'm Sam. Good to meet you. Hi, Sam. You're not Sam of Supernatural fame, are you? Sam! This is Leah. Or Leah? Leah. Hello, it's nice to meet you. Hi. Who are you? Hi, this is Penny. Oh, did you want something? Yes, I want to talk to you. I can't talk to you anymore. Ooh, this is certainly a very, very pretty game. I absolutely enjoy these 16-bit style of games. They're just so nostalgic. I mean, there is obviously the nostalgia factor. I never had an SNES, but I did have a Mega Drive, so I played a lot of kind of 16-bit era games. Absolutely love them. Ooh, I can read it in your face. You're going to love it here in Pelican Town. If you're ever looking for something to do in the evening, stop at the saloon. That's where I work. I'll be sure to do that. But it's not just this kind of nostalgia as such, but just I think there's something about this kind of art style that always looks good. It's got kind of a timeless quality to it. Like, obviously, it was big in the early 90s. Who are you? Am I just going to follow you? I'm just going to follow you. Let's see where you go. But certainly, there's just something about it that's always so beautiful. There's almost a quality to the details that you can't get in the more modern 3D style of games. Right, now I can talk to you. Can I? Hello? Hello? I'm trying to talk to you. Okay, well, that was a waste of time. Let's see. Nope, I can't cut that down. What's this? What is that? What is that? What is it? It's horseradish! Oh, cool! Right, I should probably go and do something at my farm. Oh, another person to meet. Oh, you've got a camera! Hello! Haley's too involved with her camera to notice you. What if I walk in front of your shop? Okay, she's too involved to notice me, but I'm standing in front of her shop. Hi. Never mind. Okay, she won't speak to me. That's absolutely fine. How many people have I met now? 14 out of 28. Right, so whose property was this? It's locked. Only Leah's friends can enter uninvited. Well, I won't go in there. I'm going to go back to my farm. Oh, wow, it's already 20 past three. Jeez Louise, this has been a total waste of a day. Oh, hang on, who are you? Hi. Hi. And that's the extent of the conversation. Okay. I need to... There we go. Farm is straight ahead. I need to remember the difference between left click, right click. Hoo-da! We'll get rid of some of these weeds. Oh, I'm getting fibers from them. Guessing you can do stuff with those later on. So I'm going to spend probably most of this attempt playthrough just clearing the farmland, making sure everything is starting to look nice and clear. Now, obviously, on modern farms, you don't necessarily have to do all of this work manually. You have tractors and various farming equipment that'll do most of this for you. So, like, you'll have plows on the back of your tractors, combine harvesters, and all the rest of it. I guess you can tell that I didn't do a lot in the way of the farming stuff back in Wales. I just kind of helped out now and again. Oh, frog! Damn it. This is nice. This is just kind of relaxing. It's enjoyable. Don't know how much fun it is to watch. You'll have to tell me in the comments. But it's just got such a nice vibe to it. Keep scything. Now, do you say scythe or scythe? Now, this is interesting. If you facing that way and click backwards, hola! Hola! Clicking behind you. Kind of cuts in a different direction. Interestingly enough. More seeds! I don't know what to do with mixed seeds. I guess I can find that out later. This is a decent-sized farm, actually. It's quite big. Plenty of land, plenty of room. So I'm just wondering what types of crops you can actually plant and harvest and the times of years and everything. Now, come here, frog! Oh, it got away. Start working our way upwards a bit and clear the stuff that's closer to the farm. But I'm just interested to know what you can grow. Obviously, I think the seeds I've got are... Well, I've got a wild horseradish. Parsnip seeds, those are the ones I have. So parsnips are in here. Do you have wheat? Do you have oats? I suppose we'll find out. I could have checked in the shop, actually, to see what was available. Right, it's 7:30 p.m. So, I should actually probably finish clearing some space. I'm cutting down trees. And now I need to clear some rocks. Oh, cool. Oh, I love the sound effects. Oh, so satisfying. No, that's... There we go. I'm going to plan out what to do with my farm. I'm wondering if... Oh, I found some coal! That would be great if there was coal on my farm. Absolutely brilliant. I'm mostly finding stone at the moment. Okay, so I need to go back up here. No, that's the wrong one. I need the axe. I haven't got a lot day there. I haven't gotten a lot done on day one. Cut down the tree. I like how slow. Whoa, timber! Brilliant. Look at all that wood. This is fruit. Ah, my inventory's full. Okay. I like how slowly the energy bar goes down. Like, it doesn't feel like your axe isn't strong enough to break the stump. Dang it! I was hoping to make a nice squared off plot for my parsnips. Oh well. I could do with... Hang on, if I go inside... Can I store stuff somewhere? What if I... Oh, okay, I could put it in there to sell. Maybe I shouldn't have done. I'll sell those as well. Let's see what these are. Sap! Ooh! Eat the sap! What did that do? Oh, it removes energy. That was a terrible idea. No, don't eat it. Put it back. Well, it's 11:20. Oh, I'm going to bed. It's been a long day of farming. You're not farming. Hey, I made 38. What's the currency? G. Gold? Gil? Ooh, a letter. Advertisement. I keep finding cool stuff, but my backpack is full. Does this sound like you? Well, Pierre's got you covered. Stop by Pierre's general store today and check out our affordable size 24 backpack. See you soon. That might not be a bad idea. But first, it's 6:10. Let's make lots of noise, wake the neighbors. Pickaxing the stone. Oh, the music's lovely as well. God, the amount of work that must have gone into this, it's phenomenal. Like, I'm... It's just something that's, you know, a bit strange to me, I suppose, that, you know, in this era of games where you can go into space or you can explore historical events, you can be a dragon-slaying knight, or you could be, you know, the most powerful wizard in the world. And it's just a nice, relaxing farming simulator that just kind of makes me really just sit and enjoy things, really. And, you know, I've not been playing this that long, and it's just fun. You know, when I'm aiming in the right direction. Did I just destroy that with a pickaxe? I didn't mean to do that. Yeah, it doesn't work on trees, though. Face the right way and cut it down. Haha! Right. Just a shame about that. So, here's my plan. I've got, how many? 15 seeds. So, if we start here... No, wrong way. No! Well, I suppose that works, actually. So, that's 3, 4, 5... And we start the next row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Come on. I might not have it centered properly. Hang on. Whoa, whoops. Oh, is it? Have I gone wrong somewhere? Okay, we might have done. But that's fine. It doesn't seem to want to let me go any further that way. But that's fine. There we go. Right. Let's get these planted. Parsnips! Parsnips for everyone! Beautiful, beautiful parsnips! Get them all watered. Now then. Oh, I wonder if there's a way of checking the weather forecast. Because if it's raining, you probably don't need to water these that much, I guess. Like, if it's raining, it'll water itself. That's the beauty of rain. You know, so long as it's not every single day. Wait. But I watered the letterbox. Maybe it'll grow me a new letter. Hello there, just got back from a fishing trip. You should come down to the beach sometime. I've got something for you, Willy. Okay, cool. Well, he's got something for me. I think I'm going to leave it there for now. So I've got my parsnips planted. I've cleared a little plot of land in front of my grandfather's rustic cottage. Pentrehowl Farm is going to take shape. I'm going to make it such a beautiful farm. You'll have to let me know in the comments below. Should I try and keep this fairly realistic, like in terms of growing the types of crops and keeping the type of livestock that my grandfather had at his farm? I think that'd be quite interesting, actually. I know it's not necessarily that realistic a game, but, you know, we could see how that goes in terms of just making it a little bit different, a little bit interesting. But let me know in the comments what you thought. Anyway, thank you guys so much for joining me on this one. If you liked it, hit that like button down below. As always, I'll catch you in the next video. Bye-bye!